Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on internal combustion engines. And this is lecture number 4. So here we are going to discuss about the two-stroke cycle engine. So we recap from the previous lecture. So in the previous 3 lectures, we studied about the 4-stroke cycle petrol engine, 4-stroke cycle diesel engine, the working of the petrol engine, the valve timing diagram, PV diagram, actual PV diagram, theoretical PV diagram, actual valve timing diagram, theoretical valve time diagram we have discussed, and we compared the petrol engine and the diesel engine. And now here we are going to study about the two-stroke cycle SI and CI engine, that is two-stroke cycle petrol and the diesel engine. The working principle of a two-stroke cycle petrol and diesel engine, comparison between two-stroke and the four-stroke cycle engine, theoretical and actual PV diagram, and the port timing diagram of the two-stroke cycle engine. The learning outcome for this lecture, so at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to describe the working of two-stroke cycle petrol engine and diesel engine, compare the four-stroke cycle and the two-stroke cycle engines, draw the PV diagram of two-stroke cycle petrol and the diesel engine, draw the port timing diagram of two-stroke cycle engines, and discuss on scavenging process in the two-stroke cycle engine. I look at the video for few seconds. So this is working of a two-stroke cycle petrol engine. So we have a spark plug at the cylinder head. So the piston is reciprocating, and look at here, and this is intake port. So this is called as intake port, through which the air fuel mixer from the carburetor is entering. So this valve is actuated, so the valve is opening. Actually there is a small flap type of valve that is opening, and the fresh air fuel mixer is getting into the crankcase. So this portion is crankcase. So during the piston movement, downward movement, the air fuel mixer inside the crankcase is compressed, and the compressed air fuel mixer, so through the small opening, enter into the engine cylinder, and this opening is called as transfer port, and it is compressed, combustion is taking place, and expansion, then exhaust. So this is called as exhaust port. So the intake port, transfer port, and the exhaust port. The opening and closing of the port is done by the piston movement. So look at here, the piston is closing intake port, open of the transfer port, close of the transfer port, close of the exhaust port, open of the exhaust port. So the port, 3 ports are open and closed by the movement of the piston. And all the operation, suction, compression, combustion, expansion, and exhaust, all the operations in any engine, so in the two-stroke cycle engine, they are completed in 2 strokes or 1 revolution of the crankshaft. So look at here, when 1 revolution of the crankshaft, the entire engine operations were completed. So this is two-stroke cycle petrol engine, and we will see a detailed diagram. So this is the upward stroke, this is the downward stroke of the two-stroke cycle petrol engine. And look at here, when the upward stroke, so listen here, so this is the transfer port, the transfer port is closed, exhaust port is closed, intake port is open. So the piston is almost more than 50% of the upward stroke. Now the above the top of the piston, so we have some amount of air fuel mixer which is in the compressed state. So when the piston is moving in the upward direction, so initially, first the intake port is closed, second the transfer port is closed, then the, so first the intake port is open, then the transfer port is closed, and the exhaust port is open, closed, and the air fuel mixer in the top of the piston, it is getting compressed in the compression chamber. When the piston reaches almost the top of the, when it reaches the TDC, a spark is produced here. So because of the spark, the combustion is taking place, so the gas pressure and temperature increases, and the piston is moving towards the downward. So in the downward stroke, first the intake port is closed. So the incoming of air fuel mixture is stopped. So the fresh air film mixer available in the crankcase, it is compressed because of the downward stroke. During the downward stroke, first the exhaust port is open. Then when the exhaust port is open, the burnt gases are let to the atmosphere. At the same time, the immediately after the exhaust port open, the transfer port open, the fresh air film mixer from the crankcase is rushing to the engine cylinder. So the movement of the entry of the fresh air film mixer will push the burnt gases to the atmosphere. So the in the downward stroke, first the intake port is closed, then exhaust port open and transfer port open, and the fresh air film mixer entering into the engine cylinder, which is pushing the burnt gases outside to the atmosphere. And this operation, so pushing the exhaust gases outside the engine cylinder, is called as scavenging process. And this scavenging process is done by the incoming fresh air fuel mixer. So in the case of petrol, in the case of two-stroke cycle engine, the removal of the exhaust gases is done by the fresh air fuel mixer entering into the engine cylinder. But in the case of four-stroke cycle engine, we have a separate stroke for the scavenging process, that is called as exhaust stroke. The fourth stroke is exhaust stroke, but here the exhaust or the scavenging operation is done by the incoming air fuel mixer. So the two-stroke cycle petrol engine, so in the upward stroke and downward, so there are only two strokes. In the two strokes, all the operations, the suction, compression, combustion, expansion, exhaust, everything is completed. Now we take the two-stroke cycle diesel engine. So the same kind of port. So we have the transfer port is here, exhaust port is here, and the intake port, we have a separate opening for actually this is the inlet port. So inlet port is at the bottom, and this is opened by a valve, small butterfly type of valve. So the valve will open because of the pressure difference. So when the piston is moving in the upward direction, so here in the crankcase vacuum is created, and this valve will open, and the air will enter into the engine cylinder. It will enter into the crankcase. So look at the same similar type of operation. For when it is moving in the upward direction, first the transfer port is closed, then the exhaust port is closed, and the air inside the engine cylinder is getting compressed. So using the fuel injector, a small quantity of fuel is injected. So the combustion of the air fuel mixer is taking place, and it is moving downward. So in the downward movement, so first the exhaust port open, and during the downward movement, the air inside the crankcase is getting compressed. So the compressed air is going into the engine cylinder through the transfer port. So the upward movement and the downward movement. So in the downward, look at the downward movement. First the burnt gas are going to the atmosphere, then the fresh air from the crankcase, it is entering into the engine cylinder. So again, all the operations, they are completed in the one revolution of the crankshaft or two strokes of the engine. So the only difference between the petrol engine and the diesel engine, so we have a fuel injector in the case of diesel engine, whereas in the petrol engine we have a spark plug. And among the two engine, two-stroke cycle petrol engine and two-stroke cycle diesel engine, two-stroke cycle petrol engine, they are very popular. They are used in the two-wheeler. So light vehicle, two-wheeler, mopeds, for low capacity, low weight two-wheeler. So we are using the two-stroke cycle petrol engine. And now we compare. We have two different types of engines, two-stroke cycle engine and the four-stroke cycle engine. In the four-stroke cycle engine, there are four operations are completed in four different strokes and two revolutions of the crankshaft. In the two-stroke cycle engine, the five operations are completed in a two-stroke or one revolution of the crankshaft. So now we compare the four-stroke cycle engine and the two-stroke cycle engine. So in the four-stroke cycle engine, the thermodynamic cycle is completed in four strokes of the piston or in two revolutions of the crankshaft. Thus, one power stroke is obtained in every two revolutions of the crankshaft. So, four strokes, the time record is two revolutions of the crankshaft. So, for every two revolution of the crankshaft, there is one power stroke. So, one power stroke is here in the four stroke. Whereas in the two-stroke cycle engine, the thermodynamic cycle is completed in two strokes or one revolution of the crankshaft. Thus, one power stroke is obtained in every revolution of the crankshaft. So, in the four-stroke cycle engine, for every two revolutions, there is one power stroke. And here, for every revolution, there is a power stroke. So, the two-stroke cycle engine, for the same size of the cylinder, the two-stroke cycle engine will produce more power than the four-stroke cycle engine. For the same size, remember, for the same size of the engine cylinder, the diameter and the stroke length are similar. So, same diameter, same stroke length, for the same volume or the capacity of the engine cylinder, two-stroke cycle engine will produce more power. Then, for four-stroke cycle engine, because of the above, the turning moment is not uniform, hence heavier flywheel is required. Because we require, there is only one stroke we are getting power, all the three strokes, the flywheel has to supply the power. So, the turning moment is not uniform, and hence we require a heavier flywheel to store more energy and give the energy in the remaining three strokes. So, here the turning moment is uniform almost, and the lighter flywheels can be used in the case of two-stroke cycle engine. Because of one power stroke in two revolutions of the crankshaft, lesser cooling and lubrication requirement, lower rate of wear and tear. In the case of, there is only one power stroke for every two revolutions of crankshaft, so the cooling system requirement is less, low rate of wear and tear in the case of four-stroke cycle engine. And here, because of one power stroke in one revolution, greater cooling and lubrication requirement, more amount of heat is generated. So, quickly, in more time, in a more amount of heat generated in the two-stroke cycle engine, and the cooling requirement, lubrication requirement is more, higher rate of wear and tear will occur in the case of two-stroke cycle engine. And the four-stroke cycle engine, power produced by the same size of the engine is less. Power produced by the same size of engine is more. That is what I told earlier. So, the power produced for the same size of the engine, power produced by the four-stroke cycle engine is more than the two-stroke cycle engine. The four-stroke engine contains valve and the valve actuating mechanism to open and close the valve. So, we require a separate mechanism, and this mechanism consumes power. So, the two-stroke engine do not have any valve. So, they do not have any valve, only port, and the port is open and closed by the piston movement. So, there is no power requirement for opening and closing of the port. Initial cost of the engine is more in the case of four-stroke cycle engine, and initial cost in the case of two-stroke cycle engine is less. Volumetric efficiency is more due to the more time for induction. So, in the case of, so volumetric efficiency, when the volumetric efficiency is higher, obviously the thermal efficiency is also higher. So, in the case of two-stroke cycle engine, volumetric efficiency is low due to the lesser time for the induction process. And in the four-stroke cycle engine, thermal efficiency is higher and the path load efficiency is better. So, thermal efficiency is higher and the path load efficiency? So, when the engine is operating, engine is designed for example, 10 kilowatt. When the engine is continuously operating at 10 kilowatt, it is okay. So, it is operating at the full load condition. Sometimes, due to the load demand, the engine may be operating less than the design value. The less than the design load, less than the design power is called as path load operation. So, in the path load operation, four-stroke cycle engine efficiency will be better, whereas in the case of two-stroke cycle engine, thermal efficiency is lower and the path load performance or path load efficiency is poor. And four-stroke cycle engine, they are used where the efficiency is important. For example, car, buses, tractor, power generation. And two-stroke cycle engine, they are used where the low cost, compactness and lightweight are important. For example, moped, scooter, motorcycle, hand sprayer. So, for light duty application, we are using two-stroke cycle petrol engine. For heavy duty application, we are using the four-stroke cycle engine, either petrol engine or the diesel engine. So, this is the comparison between four-stroke and the two-stroke cycle engines. And the PV diagram of two-stroke cycle petrol engine. So, look at the cylinder, piston cylinder arrangement and the corresponding pressure volume diagram. So, you start from here, bottom dead center. When the piston is at the bottom dead center, when the piston is moving towards the top dead center, first the inlet valve closes. Then exhaust valve closes, then the ignition occurs. Once the ignition occurs, the combustion is taking place. So, the petrol engine spark is produced here and the combustion is taking place, and when the piston starts to move from the top dead center, the expansion occurs and the exhaust valve opens here and the inlet valve opens here on the on this position, and then the fresh air fuel mixture is entering into the engine cylinder. So, this is what the two-stroke cycle engine and the corresponding pressure volume diagram. So, one stroke from the bottom dead center. So, here we have the bottom dead center towards the top dead center, and another stroke from the top dead center towards the bottom dead center. This is the two-stroke cycle petrol engine, and similarly two-stroke cycle diesel engine. So here what is the difference? Here the difference is ignition. So the fuel injection, actually the combustion starts here at the top. So whereas in the previous case, here the ignition occurs. So combustion somewhere starts here, and the constant volume combustion, whereas here it is constant, almost constant pressure combustion. So this is engine cylinder of two-stroke cycle diesel engine, and this is the PV diagram of the two-stroke cycle diesel engine. And looking from here, when the piston is moving from the bottom dead center to the top dead center, first the inlet valve closes, then the exhaust valve closes, and the compression process is taking place. At the end of the compression process, the fuel is injected and the ignition starts here. The almost it is a constant pressure combustion. Then when the piston starts to move from the top dead center towards the bottom dead center, the expansion occurs, power is produced, and here the exhaust valve opens and the burnt gases are sent to the atmosphere. And then further, when the piston is moving down, the inlet valve opens and the fresh air is entering into the engine cylinder. So here we call this inlet is transfer port. So inlet opens, inlet closes, that means the transfer port. Inlet port is open, the crankcase compression is taking place in the engine cylinder. So in the case of two-stroke cycle engine, the compression occurs at two levels, first in the crankcase and then in the engine cylinder. So in the case of four-stroke cycle engine, we have a separate stroke for the compression process. In the case of two-stroke cycle engine, the partially it is compressed in the crankcase and the remaining compression is taking place in the combustion chamber of the engine. And this is the port timing diagram of two-stroke cycle petrol engine. So look at the diagram. All the ports are given here. Inlet port opening, inlet port closing, transfer port opening, transfer port closing, exhaust port opening, exhaust port closing, and then spark. IS is the ignition start. So look at the diagram. We have one circle, that means one revolution of the crankshaft. So we have the top dead center and the bottom dead center, and we start from here, bottom dead center. The piston is moving from the bottom dead center to the top dead center. The transfer port is closed, that means transfer port already is open condition. First the transfer port is closed, then the exhaust port is closed. Then when the engine further moves in the upward direction, at the end towards the TDC, so inlet port opens. So you look at the diagram, the previous diagram, note down the previous diagram, note down the look at the diagram. Transfer port opens, the fresh air fuel mixer enters into the crankcase. So through the intake port, the fresh air fuel mixer is entering in the crankcase, and then the compressed air fuel mixer. So here we produce a spark, and the spark is generated here, and the combustion starts. So here the combustion, it is a higher temperature, high temperature gas is produced, and the piston moves towards the bottom dead center. So the red color line is the expansion. So when it is moving downward, when the piston is moving downward, by the movement of the piston, first the intake port is closed. So intake port is closed. So incoming, then the compression is taking place in the crankcase. So intake port is closed, and further the piston is moving downward, then the exhaust port opens. Once the exhaust port opens, so the exhaust gases, the burnt gases, are let to the atmosphere. So they are escaping to the atmosphere because of the pressure difference. And in the further movement of the piston, the transfer port opens. So once the transfer port opens, the fresh air fuel mixture is entering into the engine cylinder, which is pushing the burnt gases outside, right? So then the piston is coming to the bottom dead center. Once again, it is moving in the upward direction. So here transfer port open, and after 45 degree, the transfer port is closed. So the transfer port open 45 degree before the bottom dead center, and the transfer port is closed 45 degree after the bottom dead center, roughly 90 degree. So it will be minimum 90 degree, more than it will be 90 to 100 degree. And for exhaust port opens 60 degree before the bottom dead center, and 60 degree, roughly 60 degree after the bottom dead center. The range is 120 or 130 degree, exhaust port open to exhaust port close. Now here we have 45 degree on either side. So transfer port open to close 90 degree, and this duration is called as scavenging process. So the transfer port, when the transfer port opens, the fresh air filled mixture is entering into the engine cylinder, which is pushing the burnt gases to go to the atmosphere. That operation, removal of the burnt gases with the help of incoming air filled mixture, is called as scavenging process. And for the transfer port open to close, we have the 100 degree on either side. So 50 degree inlet port opens 50 degree before the top dead center and closes 50 degree after the top dead center. So this port timing diagram, in the laboratory you may do experiment and measure the angle, crank angle, and you can draw the port timing diagram so that you can understand, you can have the physical feeling of drawing the port timing diagram for two-stroke cycle petrol engine. And similarly, we have the port timing diagram for two-stroke cycle diesel engine. The similar type of operation, the only difference is the supply of fuel. So the fuel injection starts 10 degree before the top dead center, and the fuel supply stops 15 degree after the top dead center. That is the difference, otherwise the diagram is the same. So starting from here, bottom dead center, when the piston is moving towards the top dead center, first the transfer port is closed at 45 degree, and then the exhaust port is closed after 60 degree, then the compression is taking place. So the blue color line is compression process, and when the piston reaches the TDC 10 degree before the top dead center, the fuel injection starts and the combustion is taking place. And the once the piston reaches the top dead center and further moving downward, the expansion begins. This is the expansion process. So during the expansion, power is produced, and then when the piston is moving towards the bottom dead center at a 60 degree, exhaust port opens, then at the 45 degree transfer port opens, and the scavenging process occurs during the transfer port opening to transfer port closing. So the port timing diagram for two-stroke cycle engine is very much similar, excepting the spark generation and fuel supply. So fuel is supplied roughly 25 degree of the crank angle in the case of two-stroke cycle engine, whereas in the case of four-stroke cycle engine, it is roughly 40 degree of crank angle. So we stop here. So we have a reflection spot. We have some questions, simple questions to answer to check our understanding. The first question, thermal efficiency of two-stroke cycle petrol engine as compared to four-stroke cycle petrol engine for the same output, same speed and same compression ratio is less, more, same as long as compression ratio is the same as long as output is the same. So the question is, thermal efficiency of two-stroke cycle petrol engine as compared to four-stroke cycle petrol engine. So the quickly answer, the answer is less. So the two-stroke cycle engine's efficiency of two-stroke cycle engine is always less than the efficiency of four-stroke cycle engine. Second question, the two-stroke cycle engine has one suction valve and one exhaust valve operated by the one cam. One suction valve and one exhaust valve operated by two cams. Only ports covered and uncovered by the piston to affect the charging and exhausting. None of the above. So quickly pick up the answer. So if you have selected the C, only port covered and uncovered by the piston to affect charging and exhausting, you are correct. There is no valve in the case of two-stroke cycle engine. In two-stroke cycle engine, the process such as suction, compression, expansion, exhaust is completed in number of revolutions of the crankshaft equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. So, how many revolutions of the crankshaft in the case of two-stroke cycle engine to complete all the operations? So, if your answer is 1, you are correct. For the same size, the power produced by the four-stroke cycle engine is more than the two-stroke cycle engine. Say it is true or false. For the same size, the power produced by the four-stroke cycle engine is more than the two-stroke cycle engine. The answer is false. The power produced by the two-stroke cycle engine is more than the four-stroke cycle engine for the same size. The thermal efficiency of four-stroke cycle engine is less than the two-stroke cycle engine. Thermal efficiency of four-stroke cycle engine is more than the two-stroke cycle engine. The answer is more. So these are all the reference book I used for preparing the slides. So I have written a book on the thermal engineering. You can refer to it. The other books I have mentioned here, you can reach to it for additional information in the subject. And thank you for watching. So please post your comment on the video comment box immediately after seeing. You can post your comment. So if you have any doubts, you can write to my mail ID and you can WhatsApp to me. I will sincerely answer. Please subscribe this channel. So I have uploaded more videos on the thermal engineering subject like heat transfer, engineering thermodynamics, thermal engineering 1, thermal engineering 2, and the gate question solved also, solved gate questions answers also uploaded in the form of video. It will be useful for your better learning. So please subscribe the channel. So thank you very much. We'll meet again.